The temperatures are rising and fitness is on the minds of many here in Kamloops, all looking for tips on getting back on track.
Get back on that wagon because the wagon just keeps on moving. So if you fall off and stay off, it's going to take you that much longer. You're going to have to run that much harder to get back on it. So it's important to realize that that is part of it, myself included. Sometimes you kind of slack off, but as long as you just keep on going, because that's how you're going to move forward.
Usually people come in and they're so excited to get back started at it, and they just go too hard.
From back to legs, core and chest, we've got four simple exercises to help jumpstart your workout at the gym.
People think the core is just like the abdominals, but the core is actually anything from the hip through the rib cage. So you're working lots of different abdominal muscles through here, as well as the back, as well as obliques.
You want to make sure that your shoulders and your wrists are aligned, okay? Pulling that tummy nice and tight, good. And now come up on your toes. Right now, yep.
Good. So what we're working here is shoulders, arms, core, back, quads, everything. Pull that tummy nice and tight, and you just want to hold this position, okay? If the hips start sagging, it means the exercise, just like that. Pull them back up. If you can't hold that position, then the exercise is done, okay? Now, to make this a little bit easier, same thing, bend your knees and come down onto your knees, but still keeping a straight line through the shoulder and the hips. So keeping that torso in, and same thing, keeping your hips nice and level. But really what the core helps you do is helps with your posture, and it helps with everyday life, keeping your spine in line, keeping your body upright.
Classic push-up, I think it's great. It incorporates the plank position, nice flat back. So keep your abdominals pulled in, perfect. You're gonna bend those elbows down to a right angle and slowly back up. Good, nice and slow and controlled. Good. So if we want to take this down a little bit easier for a beginner, or if you're getting tired, you can drop down to your knees. And again, keeping that back nice and straight. It's great for the chest, front of the shoulders, and for the core.
The squat is kind of like the hoopla of all lower body exercises. It really engages everything, but basically a squat, you're working the core and everything from hips down. So quadriceps, hamstrings, glutes, and it's a very important exercise to know how to do for everyday life.
You want to take those feet about hip width apart, maybe a little bit wider. You're going to start with a slight hinge at the hip, and then you're going to bend at the knees, and you're going to tuck yourself down, good. Just like you're sitting down in a chair or a bench, good, and then come back up. So only go as far as you're comfortable. Your goal is to eventually get that thigh parallel to the floor. Good, and back up. It's really important to push those hips back, and like you're sitting down in a chair, you don't want to be leaning forward on the knees because that creates extra pressure. Very nice. Keeping the tummy pulled in super tight. Weight is on the heels. Good. Really good for the lats, the big muscles in the back, and the rhomboids, which are between the shoulder blades, again, which helps with posture, which we're really big on here at the Y. So you want to sit up nice and tall, lifting the chest, shoulders are back and down, and you're going to pull the cables just in nice and close, elbows by your side, and you want to focus on squeezing the rhomboids together here, the shoulder blades, squeezing right there. Good. So working big muscles in the back here, the lats. Nice, slow, and controlled movements. Does it feel okay? Weight's good?
Definitely having a goal in mind, writing it down, and keeping track of what you're doing, because it's really hard to measure your goal. If you just say, well, I'm gonna work out more, it's hard to measure that. So if you write down what your goal is and keep track of it, that way you can go back and look if you come closer to it, if you haven't moved forward, and you can kind of see the stumbling blocks that you've had, see how you can make a change.
Setting aside the time ahead of time. So if you look at your work week and you think about, well, what am I doing on Monday? Schedule that time. If you're busy 9 to 5, well, maybe do it before the work week, or before your work day. Because at 5 o'clock you could be tired. So set aside the time ahead, make a plan for that week and the next week, and then keep going from there. Mm-hmm.